Well, more than a century after her death, San Luis Obispo's first ever librarian is being honored with a new headstone on her previously unmarked grave. KSBY reporter Asia Gore listened in on the memorial and joins us in the newsroom with more on what some call a pioneer. Asia.
Yeah, that's exactly right. Frances Milne led a remarkable life. She was not only a founding librarian and a poet, but a suffragist championing women's rights.
She cared not for ephemeral glory. She lived for the luxury of doing good.
On a sleepy, overcast Saturday at the San Luis Obispo Cemetery, no tears, just warm smiles surround this unmarked grave.
Frances was born Frances Margaret Tenner in County Tyrone, Ireland in 1846.
Later in life, Frances moved to California and became SLO's very first librarian. Though she married and took the name Milne, her descendants say she kept the Tenner traits.
We talk about a Tenner woman, which is basically a pretty strong woman who has opinions.
A love for literature also runs in the Tenner family. While Cynthia Holmes never knew her cousin, she too was a librarian.
She was a brilliant woman.
Fellow SLO librarian Sharon Coronado learns about the literary pioneer through Frances's own work.
She was a born writer.
A remarkable writer laid to rest beside her mother and husband in 1910, perhaps ironically, without any words marking her grave.
This is in keeping with her reported avoidance of anything approaching self-aggrandizement and her focus on the needs of others.
I read some of her poetry and I didn't see anything that was outwardly not wanting a marker. And so we just felt like as librarians, it was something that we could do, and so we did it.
When you hear that she didn't want to be glorified and stuff, you know, you kind of go, oh. And then the way he put it, yeah, because it isn't her, it's the progress of the library and what it brought to the community, and that's worth honoring.
And just down the street from the San Luis Obispo Library at the History Center, Frances's old office still stands, and I'm told her old telephone even still hangs on the wall. In the newsroom, I'm Asia Gore, KSBY News.
A great way to remember her. Thank you, Asia. A GoFundMe was started for the headstone and raised over $1,200.